Progress is enormous. The Far West is no longer so.
In spite of all.
I did an evaluation of the contenders, and I am the best choice.
In 1830, the prosperous industrial centers on the east coast of the United States of America were poorly connected to the mainland. Insufficiently developed toll roads and slow ship canals were the only options when making long journeys. Farmers, businessmen, and travelers lamented these long, arduous, and above all, unsafe transport routes. They were not only an inconvenience for travelers, but also shackles on an emergent nation's hunger to grow. But at this time, a development from England was taking its first steps and helped keep alive the hope of many cities in the East of reaching greater economic influence and growth.
I've been waiting for you. I'm Philip Evan Thomas. It's always been my dream to build a railroad to the Ohio River and beyond. That would help everyone. Both the settlers and the natives. And I need your help with that. First of all, I have two tasks for you in order to build a base from where we can monitor further activities. But as I learned back when I was a bank clerk, the books must always balance. So take care to make a profit, even with these preliminary assignments.
This new fish swimming in our pond. Greetings from the beautiful city of Charlotte. What was your name again? Beautiful stranger, wasn't it? Well, that's what you look like. Just let me know if you need help push starting your trains.
Look, to be clear, I have nothing against strangers. Some of my best friends are strangers. But you're not from here, and New York is my city. That's where I do business. I say when the trains roll, where they're going, and why. As long as you don't get in my way, everything will be A-OK between us.
I see our two competitors have introduced themselves to you. They have different approaches and so will behave differently. Basically, however, they want to expand their rail networks and make a profit just like you do. So stay on guard and don't let them take advantage of you. The bigger a city gets, the greater its demands get, too. At some point, the goods from the immediate area will no longer be enough. That's where the railroad comes in handy. Now select Baltimore to take a closer look at the city. Baltimore, where the headquarters of our firm is located, has a large clothing industry. The city therefore needs a constant supply of fabrics. In New York, on the other hand, the fashion-conscious customers are waiting for deliveries of ready-tailored goods. Lay a rail line between Baltimore and New York so that the clothing produced in Baltimore can be delivered to New York.
What are you doing with this station here?
I'm already here.
I'll let you get on with your responsibilities. Stay alert. I will check on your progress from time to time.
Why are you getting in my way again? I'm gonna take your business apart. Did you see what happened? Remember, this can happen again and again.
If you transport the clothing from Baltimore with your rail line, you will be making a considerable contribution to the growth of the industry. Everyone profits from that. Excellent. You could hire train crews in the staff dialogue window. Then you'll need to view the train details of the selected train to assign the staff to it. Now open the train details of your most important train and assign an engineer and a stoker to it. You don't have first call on cities, farms, or mines. Of course, your transport income will fall if your competitors connect these to their rail networks. Tracks, locomotives, buildings, and cash all increase the value of your company. And the higher this is, the higher the price of your company stocks.